Thank you, Babe. Good evening, 大家晚上好. I'm Kelly. Just a bit of myself. I came from mainland China 18 years ago as an international student, trained as a medical doctor in China, retrained a classic migration, retrained as a registered social worker in New Zealand, been working in the health and mental health addiction for the last 15 years. I think thank you so much. You know, first of all, I want to say my congratulations to Babe and your team, project team. Really great achievement and amazing impact for this project on this particular important issue. So thank you so much. And I want to thank you, Grace, for the connection at the initial stage, because you know, you make all the effort to come to see me in the office, and there's quite a bit of drama on the parking. So we have changed our parking map. Thank you, Babe, for meeting over the Zoom. I really enjoyed the discussion. There's a lot of passion that we share aligned. So I think after talking to Grace and Babe, I just share a little bit why I want to be involved and you know, support this project. Immediately, I really committed myself because I think this is a great, we need more of those kind of projects, because in our service, you know, since the outbreak of COVID-19, many Asian people, especially Chinese, have a firsthand experience of racism and discrimination in New Zealand. And many individuals have pointed finger at Chinese and blame us the, you know, the spread of that virus. And as a service provider, a lot of Chinese clients in Auckland and contacted us with our helpline with the really distress of their children being discriminated as well as school. And we even have a Korean case that from far north that their daughter has been discriminated at school. And at the end, unfortunately, she has to move school. So this is really, you know, happening on a daily basis for our service. And so it's really heartened to, you know, see this is a great project to going on. So even my children, I have 3 children as well, primary school, they also had an experience of people telling them to go back to China. And I think I was lucky because I kind of practice a little bit at home and with them. And if people say that, what do you respond? Of course, it's really hard for them to deal with it as well. So we kind of putting mom's mental health hat on and support them, the brave and emotional support as well. So this is really happening in our life. Even in the early this year, the New Zealand Asian Mental Health and Wellbeing Report 2020 also shows that 16% Asian felt being discriminated against during this COVID-19 period. And that's about, you know, 16% is not, you know, not a lot. I like our commissioner mindset. It's, you know, even no tolerance for any percentage. So that's about 84,000 people experiencing that. That's a lot of people. I think we need to keep our key message of racism has no place in New Zealand, like our commissioner says. All New Zealanders, you know, regarding our race and color, whatever, our yellow, purple, whatever color we have, we should be respected and treated fairly and you know, welcome. Because I, you know, I put my mental health hats on that many those experiences can lead to health issues, especially mental health. And we see that, you know, victims of racial discrimination have 72% are more prone to experience serious mental health issues. And hence my service are seeing more increasing demand for mental health and emotional counseling support from our Asian community as well. I also want to take this opportunity to thank HRC Commissioner Ming Feng. I know you have done a lot of advocate work and support our community, you know, in the media and in the different campaign, national campaigns that are making a difference. And also I have been to so many of your talks and your tier list of talks and given your vision, share your vision of to all New Zealanders in different platform. We really appreciate it. I think that's really making a difference. So thank you. I also want to share, like, you know, we have Asian Family Services and myself have a really heavily promoted this project initially with our social media. We chat, we have wrote article about it in Chinese. We have done a WTV radio program in Chinese myself to raise awareness of this important project and try to encourage people. And I think even that starting of the conversation is helps as well. And finally, I would also like to congratulate all the people that participate in this poster competition. And you all the winners. I think all of beautiful art are really, I can see from my eyes that I can see the courage and creativity and your passion of want to contribute to be, you know, together we are one, and we don't want to be different from our color of skin and where we come from. And we all in this beautiful New Zealand Aotearoa. And I also want to congratulate for all the final winners. And you guys are the champion as well. I think it's great news to see that our National Museum, Te Papa, are going to hold those in, you know, Asian collection. And you are making a history. And same as with you, Babe, and your team and project team. And that's a great mark that you mark in the New Zealand history, and really be proud of yourself and be continue this work. And this is not going to end. I think we need, you know, ongoing work, ongoing champions and passion people to be, you know, like-minded and do something similar, and that making a New Zealand a better place for ourselves, for our next generation, and for all of us. Thank you.